Hello, my name is Gary Schotten, and happy to be with you again here as a part of Inspiring Better Business. Today we're going to talk about hearing God's voice. And again, most of these recent recordings are as a result of someone asking us tough questions from a developing nation. It was a very good question. We say tough questions, so how do we hear God's voice and know we're in tune? Now, if you ask 10 people, you may get 10 different answers. So in no way am I giving you the idea that this is the only answer for this. That's part of the reason for our videos, that you can hear other people talk about how they hear God's voice. It's not like I have a corner on this. I'm just sharing my experience on that. And I will say that for many years I've said, wow, I wish God would speak just a little louder. It's like it is so soft, so subtle, so insignificant that I could almost miss it. I'm telling you, I almost missed it when I was supposed to sell a company and I was really debating on it and I wasn't sure and I had to really think about it through this process, and I just would have been easier if he could have texted me or called me and just said, sell the business. Well, it doesn't work that way. It's a very small, silent voice. I will say that, I hope again when I say this, that it's not offensive to someone, but a lot of times when somebody says, hear God's voice, the answer is, well, get in your closet and pray some more, go to church, go to more Bible studies, learn about how God speaks, and all those things are important. I mean, I would be foolish to say that prayer is not important. Prayer is important. But I will say that that is not the way I have always heard God's voice for my business. Now, it's understood that I'm doing those things as a background, but my personal experience is when I want to hear God's voice, I got to do some things like, number one, take some action. Now, I don't make the decision on where to head, but I take some actions like doing research, making sure if I'm headed in a direction that there's the practical side, the application side, the things that I can do myself. I've always learned that God wants us to do what we can do ourselves, and then He's adding on top of that, like a helper would help someone through the Holy Spirit, and He's taking what we can't do ourselves or the things we wouldn't normally see from the natural way. And so, man, I'm in there digging. I mean, yes, I have my quiet time, but I'm digging in the area, in the direction that I want to go in buying a business. I was diligent. Is God leading me to buy this business? And recently we added a robot to our company, and it's a pretty big expense. Is God leading me to add that? Well, I can't say God led me. Yes, He did, but I was out there doing my research, becoming more comfortable, and you know, you've got a lot of research you can do in the area of whatever you're deciding. The natural and the supernatural need to work together, and that's how God works. Number two, in this process of hearing God's voice, after a bit, I say you need to pause and wait. So you think you heard God's voice? Sleep on it. If you think it's still in that direction the next morning, then you can make another step. Or maybe it's several weeks later. God is never in a hurry. I've always taken a position that I would rather be just slightly behind God's leading than ahead, where I'm making a mistake, and we call it taking a lap around the mountain. I made a mistake. I should have never done this. And now I've got to spend weeks, months, or years unwinding something I should have never done to begin with. So be patient and wait at the right time. And then if you've done your research, you've been patient, now the opportunity comes. You better act on it right then. You're ready to take action after you've done those two things. Then maybe three, you've got to be willing to take some risk. You know, there's some risk takers, the men of faith. Moses led the people out of Egypt into the promised land. And not everybody was happy about that. They were saying, why did you take us here? We would have been better off back in Pharaoh's, being Pharaoh's servants. We would have been better off. So faith is, and hearing God's voice is not always going to be popular to others. And you're going to have to be willing to take some risk. Gideon was fighting the battles, and he had, I think, 10,000 warriors, and they narrowed it down by elimination, a couple different eliminations, to only 300 warriors against a multitude. And God gave him a plan, and that plan was successful because they were able to hear and act on God's voice, hearing God's voice. And then, of course, there's just basic things. You've got to not avoid the basic laws of business. Start small, grow step by step. God's not going to lead you to no employees to 25 in one step. He's just not going to do it. He's going to lead you from no employees to maybe a half-time employee, part-time, to one employee, and then two employees. He's not going to give you this huge contract off the to start with. He's just not going to do it. That's my opinion. He's going to take you step by step by step, and that's the leading. You see, if you think you're going to see the whole picture before you take your first step, you're sadly mistaken. God's word talks about it being a light unto my path and a lamp unto my feet. I hope I got that right. He's not a floodlight. I'm not looking 5 years, 10 years in advance, in most of the cases, in God's leading, I'm taking my next step. I didn't say you don't plan. I'm just saying you've got to be willing to take the next step at God's leading. When God leads, you take a step. God leads again, you take another step. Now you're gaining confidence in both God, and He's gaining confidence in you that you're going to follow His leading and you're going to be on the right track. Well, I hope this helps you. Again, I've got to restate, these are just my opinions and my experience, but I think they're consistent with the Word of God. But listen to other people as well.